Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 14.3. We are going to solve problems in the hydraulic turbine. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the theory part of hydraulic turbines. The various types of hydraulic turbines like Pelton wheel, Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine, the efficiency, power output, the performance of hydraulic turbines we have discussed in the previous two lectures, and in this lecture we are going to solve problems in the hydraulic turbines. Example number 1 from May 2019 question paper, design a Pelton wheel for a head of 60 meter when running at 1200 rpm. The Pelton wheel develops 95.6475 kilowatt shaft power. The velocity of the bucket is 0.45 times the velocity of the jet. Overall efficiency is 0.85 and coefficient of velocity is 0.98. We write down the given data. The power equal to 95.6475 kilowatt, head equal to 60 meter, speed n equal to 1200 rpm, peripheral speed u equal to 0.45 times of jet speed v1, overall efficiency is 0.85 and coefficient of velocity 0.98, cv equal to 0.98. We calculate the jet velocity v1 equal to cv into square root of 2gh, so which is 0.98 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 60 equal to 33.60 meters per second. The total flow rate from the given overall efficiency and the power, we calculate the total flow rate, Q equal to shaft power divided by rho g h into overall efficiency. So 95.6475 in 10 power 3 divided by 1000 g, rho equal to 1000 into 9.81, head equal to 60 and overall efficiency is 0.85 equal to 0.19 meter cube per second. And the peripheral speed of the runner, so we are given u equal to 0.45 times of v1. So 0.45 into 33.62 equal to 15.129 meters per second. Diameter of the runner D equal to 60 u divided by pi into n. So we are defining from the definition of peripheral speed, u equal to pi dn by 60, we calculate the diameter. So 60 into 15.129 divided by 3.14 into 1200 equal to 0.241 meter. And we assume jet ratio capital D by small d equal to 6. We calculate the diameter of the jet, small d equal to diameter of the runner divided by 6. So 0.241 divided by 6 equal to 0.04 meter. So discharge per jet, Q equal to pi by 4 d square, area of the jet into velocity. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.04 square into 33.60 equal to 0.0422 meter cube per second. The number of jet required, total discharge divided by the discharge per jet, so 0.19 divided by 0.0422 equal to 4.5 equal to 5. So 5 numbers of jets are required. The answer to the problem, diameter of the wheel capital D equal to 0.241 meter, diameter of the jet or jet diameter is small d equal to 0.04 meter, and number of jet required equal to 5. Example number 2 from November 2019 question paper, a Pelton wheel is having a mean bucket diameter of 1 meter and is running at 1000 rpm. The net head on the Pelton wheel is 700 meter. If the side clearance angle is 15 degree and discharge through the nozzle is 0.1 meter cube per second, find the power available at the nozzle and the hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. Take coefficient of velocity CV equal to 1. So write down the given data, diameter equal to 1 meter, speed equal to 1000 rpm, head 700 meter, side clearance angle phi equal to 15 degree, discharge q equal to 0.1 meter cube per second and cv equal to 1. We calculate the jet velocity, v1 equal to cv into square root of 2gh, so 1 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 700 equal to 117.19 meter per second. We calculate the peripheral speed, u equal to pi dn by 60, so 3.14 into 1 into 1000 divided by 60 equal to 52.33 meters per second. So the power available at the nozzle, this is rho q into v1 square by 2. to 1000 into 0.1 into 117.19 whole square divided by 2, which is 6.87 × 10⁵ watts. This is the power available, water power available at the outlet of the nozzle. And power developed by the runner. So P equal to rho Q U into V1 minus U plus 1 plus cos phi. So 1000 into 0.1 into 52.33 into 117.19 minus 52.33 into 1 plus cos 15. So calculating, it is 6.67 × 10⁵ watts. So hydraulic efficiency equal to the formula U into V1 minus U into 1 plus cos phi divided by V1 square by 2. So 52.33 into 117.19 minus 52.33 into 1 plus cos phi 15 divided by 117.19 square divided by 2 equal to 0.972, which is 97.2%. The answer to the problem, the power available at the nozzle 6.87 × 10⁵ watts and the hydraulic efficiency is 97.2%. Example number 3 from May 2010 question paper. A Pelton wheel is to be designed for the following specification. Shaft power is 11772 kilowatts, head equal to 380 meters, speed equal to 750 rpm, overall efficiency is 86%, jet diameter is not to exceed one sixth of the diameter of the wheel. Determine wheel diameter, number of jets required and the diameter of the jet. So, we write down the given data. It is Pelton wheel, shaft power equal to 11772 kilowatts, head equal to 380 meter, speed equal to 750 rpm, overall efficiency 0.86 and the diameter of the jet equal to diameter of the wheel divided by 6, small d equal to capital D by 6. So, we calculate the jet velocity, V1 equal to square root of 2gh. So, substituting, so CV is not given, we assume CV equal to 1. So 2 into 9.8 into 380 equal to 86.34 meters per second. And the total flow rate from the definition of overall efficiency, flow rate Q equal to shaft power divided by rho GH into overall efficiency. So 11772 into 10 power 3 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 380 into 0.86 equal to 3.67 meter cube per second. And we assume speed ratio phi equal to 0.46. So, the peripheral speed of the runner U equal to phi into V1, 0.46 into 86.34, this is equal to 39.72 meters per second. And from the peripheral speed, we calculate the diameter of the runner, D capital D equal to 60 U divided by phi into N. So, 60 into 39.72 divided by 3.14 into 750 equal to 1.012 meter. And diameter of the jet, small d equal to capital D by 6, 1.012 divided by 6 equal to 0.17 meter. And diameter discharge per jet equal to area of the jet pi by 4 d square in the velocity of the jet V1. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.17 square into 86.34 equal to 1.96 meter cube per second. And number of jet required equal to total discharge divided by the discharge per jet. So 3.69 divided by 1.96 equal to 1.88, which is 2. So we require 2 numbers of jet. The answer to the problem, diameter of the wheel, capital D equal to 1.012 meter, diameter of the jet, small d equal to 0.17 meter, and number of jet required equal to 2. The next example, example number 4, a double jet Pelton wheel is required to generate 7500 kilowatt. When the available head at the base of the nozzle is 400 meter. The jet is deflected to 165 degree and the relative velocity of the jet is reduced by 15% by passing over the packet. Determine the diameter of the jet, total flow rate, force exerted by the jet in the tangential direction. Assume generator efficiency is 95%, overall efficiency is 80%, speed ratio 0.47 and the coefficient of velocity 0.97. This is from May 2019 question paper. So, given data, number of jet equal to 2, power equal to 7500 kilowatt, head equal to 400 meter, phi, the deflection angle is 180 minus 165. So, jet deflected by 165 degree, the clearance angle is 15 degree, VR2 equal to 0.85 times of VR1. So, there is a loss of relative velocity when the flow is over the bucket. Generator efficiency 0.95, overall efficiency 0.8, speed ratio 0.47 and coefficient velocity 0.97. So we calculate the jet velocity. V1 equal to Cv into square root of 2gh. So 0.97 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 400 equal to 85.93 meters per second. The peripheral speed, so from the speed ratio, U equal to speed ratio into V1, 0.47 into 85.93 equal to 40.39 meters per second. Then calculate the flow rate from the definition of overall efficiency and the generator efficiency. Discharge equal to shaft power divided by rho gh into generator efficiency into overall efficiency. So 7500 into 10 power 3 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 400 into 0.95 into 0.8 equal to 2.51 meter cube per second. Then mass flow rate m equal to rho into q, 1000 into 2.51 equal to 2510 kilograms per second. Discharge per jet, small q equal to, there are two jets in the problem, 2.51 divided by t equal to 1.255 meter cube per second. So diameter of the jet, from the definition of the discharge per jet, q equal to pi by 4 d1 square into v1. So d1 equal to 4q divided by pi v1 square root. So square root of 4 into 1.255 divided by 3.14 into 85.93 equal to 0.136 meter. So this is the velocity triangle for the Pelton wheel. So inlet velocity triangle, velocity v1 is the inlet velocity, which is equal to whirl velocity or tangential velocity. And the water is deflected leaving with the VR2. So VR1 is here. VR1 equal to V1 minus U1 and VR2 is the outlet velocity. Phi is the angle, clearance angle. U2 is the peripheral speed. So VR1 equal to V1 minus U. So 85.93 minus 40.39 equal to 45.54 meters per second. Relative velocity at the outlet, VR2 equal to 0.85 into VR1, which is 0.85 into 45.54 equal to 38.71 meters per second. So, whirl velocity at the outlet, VWT equal to VR2 cos phi minus U. So, from the velocity triangle, outlet velocity triangle, VWT equal to VR2 cos phi minus U, which is 38.71 into cos 15 minus 40.39 equal to minus 3 meters per second. So, the tangential force Fx equal to M into VW1 minus VW2. So, VW1 equal to V1. So, M into V1 minus VW2. So, the VWT is minus value. So, this minus sign will become plus. So, Fx equal to 2510 into 85.93 plus 3 equal to 223.3 into 10 power 3 Newton. So, the answer to the problem, diameter of the jet 0.136 meter. Discharge 2.51 meter cube per second and tangential force equal to 223.2 kilonewton. Example number 5 from May 2006 question paper. A Pelton wheel works under a gross head of 510 meter. One third of the gross head is lost in the friction in the penstock. The rate of flow rate through the nozzle is 2.2 meter cube per second. The angle of deflection of the jet is 165 degree. Find the power given by water to the runner, hydraulic efficiency of the Pelton wheel. You take Cv equal to 1, coefficient velocity equal to 1 and the speed ratio equal to 0.45. So, this is from May 2006 question paper. The head equal to 10 meter, head loss equal to 1 by 3 times of head. Rate of flow Q equal to 2.2 meter cube per second, angle of deflection is 165 degree, Cv equal to 1, speed ratio equal to 0.45. So, in the net head available, h equal to h minus 0.33 times of h. So, 510 into 0.33, 1 third equal to 0.333. So, 0.333 into 510 equal to 340 meter. Jet velocity equal to V1 equal to Cv into square root of 2gh. So, 1 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 340 equal to 81.67 meters per second. And peripheral speed, from the definition of speed ratio, peripheral speed U equal to pi into V1. So, 0.45 into 81.67 equal to 36.75 meters per second. Then the tip angle at the runner, phi equal to 180 minus 165 equal to 15 degree. Power given by water to the runner, so equal to rho q into v1 square by 2, which is 1000 into 2.2 into 81.67 square divided by 2 equal to 7.336 in 10 power 6 watts. This is the power of water given to the runner at the inlet of the runner. Then the hydraulic efficiency, eta h equal to u into v1 minus u into 1 plus cos phi divided by v1 square by 2. So, So substituting numerical value is 36.75 into 81.67 minus 36.75 into 1 plus cos 15 divided by 81.67 square divided by 2, which is 0.973, which is 97.3%. The answer to the problem, power given by the water to the runner 7.336 megawatts, hydraulic efficiency is 97.3%. We stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. So you may find the fluid mechanics and machinery. For additional theory or problem, you can refer to the book in the hydraulic turbine. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video lecture on the problems on the hydraulic turbine. Until then, bye bye.